Putin of Russia, he said, Trump is a genius, he'll be the next leader. And by the way, wouldn't it be nice if we actually got along with Russia? Wouldn't that be nice?
Angela Merkel, who is, I mean, do you see what's going on? And we talk about immigration, we talk about borders. Do you see what she's done to Germany? Just coming over, just before this morning, I'm watching television. The rapes, the riots, what's happening is unbelievable. It's unbelievable, unthinkable. Hundreds and hundreds of rapes on New Year's Eve. Germany, they have a problem. She went off the reserve. I don't know what happened to her. She was doing well. Maybe she got power hungry. Maybe she thought she was invincible. They're taking people. The crime is astronomical. It's not working. They're having riots now in the street. And the German people are saying, we've had it. We've had it. In short, Hillary Clinton wants to be America's Angela Merkel. And you know what a disaster this massive immigration has been to Germany and the people of Germany. Crime has risen to levels that no one thought they would ever, ever see. It is a catastrophe. We have enough problems in our country. We don't need more.
And now you look at what's happening in Germany. So I used to be a fan of Merkel. I used to think she was terrific, a big leader, a great leader. I think what she did to Germany is a disgrace. Is a disgrace. It's a total disgrace.
I do not like the migration. I do not like the people coming. Frankly, look, Europe's going to have to handle, but they're going to have riots in Germany. What's happening in Germany, I always thought Merkel was like this great leader. What she's done in Germany is insane. It's insane. They're having all sorts of attacks. They're having
you mean
all
letting
sorts
in
of,
the
Letting
the
in
refugees.
That many people. And I've been watching this migration, and I see the people. I mean, they're men. They're mostly men, and they're strong men. These are physically young, strong men. They look like prime-time soldiers. Now, it's probably not true, but where are the women? You see some women, you see some children, but for the most part, I'm looking at these strong men. So you ask two things. Number one, why aren't they fighting for their country? And number two, I don't want these people coming over here. And even on a humanitarian, you know, when I was first asked this question, you asked it to me a long time ago, when they were talking about 3,000 people, I begrudgingly would say, oh, maybe, I don't know. Maybe.
Letting them into the United States.
A little
States.
Bit. Then they said 10,000. I'm not thrilled, but maybe 200,000 people. This could be the greatest Trojan horse. This could make the Trojan horse look like peanuts if these people turned out to be a lot of ice.
I'm putting the people on notice that are coming here from Syria as part of this mass migration, that if I win, they're going back. They're going back. I'm telling you. They're going back.
So we protect Germany. Germany is a behemoth, an economic behemoth. It's being destroyed by what Merkel has done there, what she has done to Germany. I have friends from Germany. They're leaving Germany. They're leaving Germany. These are people who were so proud a year ago of being German people. They were so proud. They used to brag. I said, "You're still proud?" "Not so proud." They're leaving Germany. They're moving to other countries. What she's done, I don't know what happened to her. I thought she was a terrific leader.
Meine Damen und Herren, ich gratuliere dem Gewinner der Präsidentschaftswahl in den Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika, Donald Trump, zu seinem Wahlsieg. Die Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika sind eine alte und ehrwürdige Demokratie. Der Wahlkampf in diesem Jahr war ein besonderer, mit zum Teil schwer erträglicher Konfrontation. Ich habe also, wie wohl die allermeisten von Ihnen, dem Wahlausgang mit besonderer Spannung entgegengesehen. Wen das amerikanische Volk in freien und fairen Wahlen zu seinem Präsidenten wählt, das hat Bedeutung weit über die USA hinaus. Für uns Deutsche gilt, mit keinem Land außerhalb der Europäischen Union haben wir eine tiefere Verbindung als mit den Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika. Wer dieses große Land regiert, mit seiner gewaltigen wirtschaftlichen Stärke, seinem militärischen Potenzial, seiner kulturellen Prägekraft, der trägt Verantwortung, die beinahe überall auf der Welt zu spüren ist. Die Amerikanerinnen und Amerikaner haben entschieden, dass diese Verantwortung in den nächsten 4 Jahren Donald Trump tragen soll. Deutschland und Amerika sind durch Werte verbunden. Demokratie, Freiheit, den Respekt vor dem Recht und der Würde des Menschen, unabhängig von Herkunft, Hautfarbe, Religion, Geschlecht, sexueller Orientierung oder politischer Einstellung. Auf der Basis dieser Werte biete ich dem künftigen Präsidenten der Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika, Donald Trump, eine enge Zusammenarbeit an. Die Partnerschaft mit den USA ist und bleibt ein Grundstein der deutschen Außenpolitik, damit wir die großen Herausforderungen unserer Zeit bewältigen können. Das Streben nach wirtschaftlichem und sozialem Wohlergehen, das Bemühen um eine vorausschauende Klimapolitik, den Kampf gegen Terrorismus, Armut, Hunger und Krankheiten, den Einsatz für Frieden und Freiheit in Deutschland, in Europa und in der Welt. Ich danke Ihnen.
Cologne never had a problem. Cologne, Germany. Okay? Everything's fine. Everything's nice, clean, beautiful, no problem. Now they're having riots. They're having rapes. The New Year's Eve has, have you heard about the New Year's Eve? It was like a disaster. And the German people are going to riot. The German people are going to end up overthrowing this woman. I don't know what the hell she's thinking. But they have millions of people pouring into Germany.